They call it adversity, I call it opportunity. They call it weakness, I call it strength. They call me disabled, I call myself differently able. They see my disability, I see my ability. There are some incidents that happen in your life, and those incidents are so strong that they change your DNA. Those incidents or accidents are so strong that they break you physically. They deform your body, but they transform your soul. I was 18 years old when I got married. I belonged to a very conservative family, a Baloch family, where good daughters never say no to their parents. My father wanted me to get married, and all I said was, if that makes you happy, I'll say yes. And of course, it was never a happy marriage. Just about after 2 years of getting married, I met a car accident. Somehow my husband fell asleep and the car fell in the ditch. He managed to jump out, saved himself. I'm happy for him. But I stayed inside the car and I sustained a lot of injuries. The list is a bit long. Radius ulna of my right arm were fractured. The wrist was fractured. Shoulder bone and collarbone were fractured. My whole rib cage got fractured. And because of the rib cage injury, lungs and liver were badly injured. I couldn't breathe. I lost urine and bowel control. That's why I have to wear the bag wherever I go. One day, doctor came to me and he said, well, I heard that you wanted to be an artist, but you ended up being a housewife. I have a bad news for you. You won't be able to paint again because your wrist and your arm are so deformed, you won't be able to hold a pen again. And I stayed quiet. Next day, doctor came to me and said, your spine injury is so bad, you won't be able to walk again. I took a deep breath and I said, it's all right. The next day, doctor came to me and said, because of your spine injury and the fixation that you have in your back, you won't be able to give birth to a child again. That day, I was devastated. I still remember, I asked my mother, why me? And that is where I started to question my existence. Why am I even alive? What's the point of living? People are scared. They think I will get divorced. What is going to happen to me? But I'm tired of looking at these white walls in the hospital and wearing these white scrubs. I'm getting tired of this. I want to add more colors to my life. I want to do something. Bring me some colors. Bring me some small canvas. I want to paint. So the very first painting I made was on my deathbed, where I painted for the very first time. It was not just an art piece or just my passion. It was my therapy. And then I was discharged and I went back home. And I went back home and I realized that I have developed a lot of pressure ulcers on my back and on my hip bone. I was unable to sit. There were a lot of infections in my body, a lot of allergies. So doctors wanted me to lie down on the bed straight for not 6 months, for not 1 year. For 2 years, I was bedridden. That was the time where I realized how lucky people are, but they don't realize. After 2 years and 2.5 months, when I was able to sit on a wheelchair, that was the day when I had the rebirth. I saw myself in the mirror and I talked to myself. So I applied the lip color for the first time and I cried and I said, what am I doing? A person on a wheelchair should not do this. What will people say? Clean it up. Put it again. This time I put it for myself because I wanted to feel perfect from within. And that day I decided that I'm going to live life for myself. I am not going to be that perfect person for someone. I am just going to take this moment and I will make it perfect for myself. That day I decided that I'm going to fight my fears. You know what was my biggest fear? Divorce. I couldn't stand this word. I was trying to cling on to this person who didn't want me anymore, but I said no. That the day I got the news that he's getting married, I sent him a text that I'm so happy for you and I wish you all the best. And he knows that I pray for him today. I won't be able to be a mother again. And that was quite devastating for me. But then I realized there are so many children in the world, all they want is acceptance. So there is no point of crying, just go and adopt one. 2 years later, I got this call from a very small city in Pakistan. I got a call and they said, are you Muniba Mazari? There is a baby boy and would you like to adopt? And when I say yes, I could literally feel the labor pain. I said, yes, yes, I am going to adopt him. I am coming to take him home. You know, when you end up being on the wheelchair, what's the most painful thing? That's another fear that people on the wheelchair or the people who are differently able have in their hearts, but they never share. I'll share that with you. The lack of acceptance. People think that they will not be accepted by other people because we, in the world of perfect people, are imperfect. So I decided that instead of starting an NGO for disability awareness, which I know will not help anyone, I started to appear more in public. I started to paint. I always wanted to. Do not think that you alone can achieve things. No. There is always another person who is standing behind you, maybe not coming on the forefront, but behind you, praying for you and supporting you. Never lose that person. Never. Somebody's absence makes you a better person. Cherish their absence. It's always a blessing in disguise. There are so many people in the world who are dreaming to live a life that you are living right now. You have no idea. Embrace each and every breath that you are taking. Celebrate your life. Live it. Don't die before your death. You work hard, you make money. You do it for yourself. That's not life. You go out, you seek for people who need your help. You make their lives better. You become that sponge which can absorb all the negativity, and you become that person who can emit beautiful, positive vibes. And when you realize that you have changed someone's life, and because of you, this person didn't give up. That is the day when you live. Love yourself and spread that love. Life will be hard. There will be turmoils. There will be trials, but that will only make you stronger. Never give up. The real happiness doesn't lie in money or success or fame. I have this all, I never wanted this. Real happiness lies in gratitude. So be grateful, be alive, and live every moment.